They'll be watching for me. I need to be careful.
Στους αγρούς. Αγέλα εγκαταλείπτω.
A power I wield indeed. I told you last time I thought I could summon you when needed, and it has happened yet again.
And for what this time?
My friend here needs to be taken to the sanctuary of Elefsis, near the border of Mecharis. He'll finish the trek across the border on his own.
I'm always happy to help a friend of yours. Is this one drunk as well?
Not at all. And that politician was not my friend.
Let's get to it. I'm just supposed to take your friend across the border.
Yes.
Nothing else?
Carefully, if you can. Avoid roads, people. Be invisible. My friend must be kept safe.
I'll make sure he's safe.
I'd hoped you'd say that.
Every time you ask me to do something secretly, someone dies. What is it this time?
Not everyone was born with your beautiful muscles built for, well, everything. Some of us work better by avoiding fights. This time, that's all I ask.
There are lots of safe passages through these parts. Tell your friend to go alone.
He could, but imagine if something happened and you saved him. Imagine the things I'd do to show my gratitude.
And why do you always turn to me?
You've proven yourself worthy. Plus, I like watching you walk away.
We should be on our way.
He needs to get to the sanctuary of Elefsis. It isn't far, although it may take you longer than usual.
It won't be a problem.
I'm glad we aren't going by sea. Alcibiades told me about you. He said you're blessed by the gods.
Let's go.
Ucares told me to go.
Come on.
That's better. I was starting to get sweaty under that hood.
You're a woman.
Nice of you to notice.
Alcibiades said...
Exactly what I told him to. It was safer that way. I owe Alcibiades a lot for his help. And for trusting you with my life as well.
Enough lies. Tell me what's happening.
I said I was a man, so nobody would recognize me. I needed to escape my husband, unseen.
And you trusted Alcibiades?
No one escapes my husband. He'd find me. It's been tough. I'm not sure I would have lasted much longer.
I'm glad I could help.
Please give Alcibiades my thanks. I only wish I had more to offer him. And you, for the help. I'll never forget either of you.
Better stay hidden.
The sun and moon combined could not grant the beauty that my bride-to-be was gifted. If the gods blessed me, they did so with one eye closed. But their eyes were wide open for her.
Please stop. Your poetry is sweet enough to make someone vomit.
I won't stop until the whole world knows how I feel.
So, you're in love?
Yes, the wedding nears, and there is so much to be done.
If you need help, I'm here for you.
Accepting before knowing what I ask of you? That's a rare surprise. I do still need a few things. Food for an offering, a ring, and some flowers. If you could bring them to my bride, Iris, she'll make use of them.
I've known you for a while now, but you've never mentioned Iris.
There's plenty I haven't mentioned. I'm sure you could say the same to me.
So what is it about Iris that turns you into, well, what I saw?
You're not jealous, are you? Don't worry. She's very open. I suppose that's one of my favorite things about her. The openness.
So, flowers, a ring, and food. Where can I find Iris?
She should be at the Altar of Love. Aptly named, don't you think? Oh, and don't be too taken by her beauty.
Thank you. found it. There it is. Here it is. I think this would be a nice enough offering. To stay out of sight. These flowers should be good enough for the wedding. Hopefully this jewelry is up to Alcibiades' standards.
Let me guess. Alcibiades sent you.
He did. How did you know?
He has a skill for making others do things he doesn't want to. On top of that, he prefers if those people are attractive. He's so predictable. It's what made this whole thing so easy.
It almost sounds like you're using him. What has been easy?
Making him fall in love with me, of course. Please, Alcibiades is not the man you marry for love.
Then why are you marrying him?
Alcibiades has a true chance of ruling one day. Well, he'll be the face, but I'll be the one truly leading. The Aspasia to his Pericles.
How can you treat someone like Alcibiades that way?
Oh, please. If anyone deserves it, it's Alcibiades. Surely you've noticed. The obsession with sex, the lies, the drinking.
So lying to him is what he deserves?
Of course. And it's not like he'll get nothing in return. I mean, look at me.
And what if I tell Alcibiades all of this?
Why would you? You've seen him. He's happy. And I'll make sure he stays that way. There's nothing wrong with me getting something in return. But it's your choice. Thanks for helping with the wedding. Please, I have a lot to attend to.
It's all done.
Wonderful. So, what did you think about Iris?
You found a good one. I can see what you like about her.
I knew you would. Even though nothing could change my mind about her, it's always nice to get confirmation from others.
I hope you two are happy. You seem perfect for one another.
We'll be more than happy. Thank you for your help, Cassandra. I hope this isn't the last time we meet.
Good luck with everything, Alcibiades. If you ever need anything, find someone else.
We both know you'll gladly help me again.
We'll see.
yours. Prepare mine.
Is that Cassandra of Aeaid, the Eagle Bearer, messenger of Zeus, she who launched a thousand hearts?
Alcibiades. I'm known by many names, but that last one sounds to be of your own making.
My young friend Orchimedes here could use your legendary talents to woo the object of his desire.
You would have my eternal gratitude.
I'd like to know more about the man asking for my help.
I'm Orchimedes. I came to Alcibiades because he boasts of his exploits as a lover and knows Braxila.
I'm Amisthios, not some famed lover.
I heard that Cassandra learned a special healing touch from Lycaon.
What's the job?
Have you ever heard of Braxila?
The name sounds familiar. Who is she?
Who is she? A poet, blessed by Apollo himself. She describes the gods as if they were her lovers. Her lyre is a legendary weapon, wielded in her hands. I want to meet her, but talking to a goddess such as she? Terrifying.
Oh, nonsense. Usually you give a woman some flowers, and she'll show you her flower. However, this is Praxila. She is not easily impressed.
Of course. No ordinary flower will do. They need to be worthy of a goddess.
I come to this coast every year for the poetry festival. Of all the beautiful blossoms, none match the scent and radiance of the coral rose. Fetch some, and all doors and legs shall open for you.
I'll return with your flowers. Where can I find the coral rose? It sounds rare.
You would be correct. However, like all good things in life, these take more work than most are willing to expend. They're atop a nearby mountain.
Say I do get these flowers. Where would I bring them?
Back to camp? Braxila should be in her tent.
You mentioned being here for a poetry festival?
I did. It's one of the many festivals to Apollo, but this one holds a special place in my heart, among other places. Other festivals are so stuffy. Here we worship like maenads.
I've heard enough.
Please, if you are as skilled with sword and heart as Alcibiades says, you'll return to me with the coral rose. As a poet, it's best that I stay at camp while you do the hiking.
You'd be an easy snack for wolves or bears. I'll return with the roses.
These must be the coral roses. I found your coral roses.
You're back! That's perfect. The roses are perfect. Oh, look at the luster. The fragrance. Now, you must deliver them to her.
You came all this way to meet her. You should be the one to do it.
Please, I'm much too nervous to speak to her. I've composed a poem to recite. Here. Let me teach you.
I'd say it all wrong. I'm a mystios, not a poet.
Then, would you at least deliver the flowers while I rehearse?
Fine. But the rest is up to you.
Okay. She's at her tent. It's right there. Go give them to her.
Praxila. I have flowers for you from Orchimedes of... somewhere.
Did I not tell you to get the wine 5 minutes ago?
Cassandra Vaillard, may I introduce you to my dear friend Praxila, Apollo's muse and mistress of the Golden Strings.
Your Praxila?
Didn't expect an aged bard, mercenary of Ayad.
It would be foolish of me to assume a master of the craft would be young.
Praxila, this is Cassandra Vaillard, eagle-bearer, messenger of Zeus, launcher of 1,000...
Cassandra Kaka, cast stone and light alike, leaves ladies and lads alight alive. Ailing women and awestruck men cling to her side.
Ah, a true genius.
Look at those shoulders. A soldier, a Spartan, a thorn in the side of tyrants. She who dares challenge Poseidon. Alcibiades, this one I'm keeping my eyes on.
The poems she writes about me are never so kind.
I have flowers for you. They're not from me. They're from Orchimedes. He's right over... Well, he was over there.
A coral rose? I'll have to get my servant to add these to the pile.
I also prefer actions to easy gestures.
Where is that serpent girl? I swear her head must be rattling with rocks.
I wish she'd rattle my rocks.
A Haikos is missing. That idiot must have taken it with her and run off.
A Haikos?
A Haikos is Praxila's legendary lyre.
They set it down after tuning moments before you arrived. I can't go on stage without a Haikos.
I did see Orchimedes leaving in quite a hurry.
We need to get that lyre back. Please, without Praxila getting everyone's juices flowing, this festival is just a bunch of young men measuring the size of their verse.
This lyre was special. Can you play another for your recital?
Perseus without winged sandals or a mirrored shield was just a man. Would he have the same legends, the same mystery, if he performed each task without a legendary weapon?
It's very valuable, both in significance and in drachmi.
Orchimedes and the missing servant both disappeared as the lyre was stolen. They could be working together.
Oh, and he seemed like such a nice boy.
Alcibiades invited a viper into my tent.
Is there somewhere they could have taken it?
It's a poetry festival. There is no better hub for shady trade.
I'll find the thief and return the lyre. Praxila's lyre has gone missing. Have you seen it?
Praxila's lyre is missing? That's terrible news. First Noev repeated this, and now this? Krefsis really has gone to the dogs.
I'm looking for a man named Orchimedes.
I know an Archimedes. Otherwise, no.
He might have been holding a lyre?
There are as many men holding lyres here as there are blades of grass on a field.
I'm looking for a missing lyre.
Aren't we all?
Are we? Do you know a man named Orchimedes?
Orchimedes? Orchimedes. That's the kid who hangs out around the vipers. Yeah, I know him. He's been coming to the festival for 3 or 4 years, maybe.
The vipers? Who are they?
You know how it is. People feel small, so they band together to make the rest of us feel smaller. They took over the temple of Athena Itonia a while back. Now it's hard to take the road without being held at knife point.
Do you think that's where Orchimedes would take a lyre?
Hope not, for his sake. The vipers are dangerous. If he did have the lyre on him, they'd probably rough him up for it. He's one of those kids they'd be keeping around for fodder, if you get me.
Did he have a lyre on him?
I didn't see him with one. I saw him talking to you, then walking towards Praxila's tent. He and Praxila's pretty elot have been sneaking around lots. Just assume they were, you know, planting a garden.
Is the Temple of Athena the best place to sell a stolen lyre?
You can buy and sell anything here, unfortunately. But going to the vipers guarantees the person you stole from won't follow you in. Shame. It was such a beautiful temple.
Thank you for your help.
Hope you find the lyre. Watch out for the vipers at the Temple of Athena Itonia.
That servant, the one who disappeared at the same time as the liar.
I can explain. Archimedes talked me into it and said he'd use the drachmi to buy my freedom. When we escaped, he said he wanted to bring the liar to the vipers. I said no. The vipers said yes.
So, the vipers have Archimedes and the liar now. As for you, you can go back to Praxila and apologize if you really want help. That must be where they're keeping Archimedes and the liar.
Thank the gods I'm safe. These horrible thugs blackmailed me into stealing the lyre.
I doubt that.
They took it from me when I was captured. Malaka! Got what they deserved.
Did they force you to steal Praxila's lyre?
No. They gave me the confidence I was lacking. We would drink and complain about poetry at the festival, and I let slip that Praxila's my mother.
What? Praxila's your mother?
She is. She abandoned me and my father when I was a child. Something about following her destiny to be a wandering poet. My father, Achaikos, built the lyre for her as a wedding present. She loved it more than us. I wanted her to feel the way we did when she left.
Praxila was born with a calling for the arts. It was her right to follow it.
She should have thought of that before she decided to have a family. I wish my father had never made her that lyre.
Speaking of the lyre, I know you have it.
Malaka, I do. But it was damaged in the struggle. Wait! Before you leave, I need some advice. Should I talk to Praxila? I don't know what to do.
Approach Praxila as yourself and talk to her. Maybe she missed you and didn't know how to come home.
I need time to think about everything. My father, my mother, my friends. Please don't tell Praxila who I am.
I was able to get the lyre, but not in one piece.
Thank you. Oh, Haikos, what mischief did you get yourself into? Oh, Cassandra, thwarter of thieves. I appreciate you bringing a Haikos back to me, but I need to ask another favor.
You need help fixing the lyre.
Perceptive, too. Look at it. Wood's gone soft, body splintered, it's toneless, tuneless even.
What can be done to save it?
Cressis has been having this festival for years. The town is built around it. Of course, because instruments are as fragile as a poet's heart, there's a master lyre maker at Cressis port.
Not too far away.
And since it's been proven that nothing is safe on these hills, I'll need some muscle for protection.
I can help you get there safely.
The journey will be worth your while. Come now.
I'm right behind you.
I have many fond memories of this place. I've watched the port grow into a town, and a small gathering of friends grow into a massive festival. It's more home than home.
Your true love is a lyre, and your home is a poetry festival? You never wanted to settle somewhere?
You sweet young child. My life isn't as simple as you make it out to be. I'm like Zephyros, needing to go where I please. I learned this the hard way.
So you care only for yourself?
If you only live your life for others, what's the point? You're nothing but a slave. A loyal beast at best.
People can get hurt.
If I had lived a life expected of me, traditional and domestic, I wouldn't die. died inside, and like as not, thrown myself into the sea. I know what I need.
Seems like the festival here is much less formal than the others I've encountered.
Yes, Dionysus claimed our offerings to Apollo and granted us the gift of ecstasy.
I can see why it would attract people from far and wide.
Do not misunderstand. Heathen is one part of worship, but there are many here who dedicate themselves. Dimicha, where are you?
Who is making all that fucking noise?
The smell of the sea is almost enough to cover your stench, Dimicha.
Raxila, I've been gathering fruits to throw at you all week.
High praise coming from you. I need a favor. Achaikos was kidnapped by some idiot and needs a new neck.
This idiot?
Sadly, there have been many idiots on this journey.
I hired this muscle here to get Achaikos back. Now she's keeping me company.
All right. Give him here. Our fellow's been brutalized.
But you can fix it, right?
Of course I can fix him. I am the best pair of hands you're going to find outside of Athens. Problem is, Achaikos is a special boy. I have materials, but nothing worthy of putting him together.
What materials do you need?
I have what I need for the neck, but the old one took the strings and yoke out when it snapped. Ah, there's a crack running through the soundbox. That needs to be replaced.
What should I be looking for?
Some use bone for the yoke and neck, but nothing beats wood in my opinion. Strings are made from gut, and we could use a shell for the soundbox.
Those strings don't look like guts to me.
They are. Just soaked for a long time and pulled thin. I'm sure you'll enjoy killing some legendary beast to help a Achaikos sing.
I've seen some lyres with turtle shells for the body.
Not a lot of turtles on this coast, but a good sturdy conch should do the trick.
What's a yoke? And what wood do you need to replace it?
The yoke is the crossbar that all of the strings are attached to.
Sure is. It needs to bend, so a springy wood is best.
I think we all can agree on that.
I will return with the materials to repair Achaikos. Animals. I'll gut them for Praxi. Hope these are enough guts for fixing a Achaikos. This shell should be perfect for Praxila's lyre. That should be enough wood for a new lyre. I have everything we need.
Excellent. Give it here.
Be careful with it.
He like me better when I'm done. You always were too rough with your fingering.
Well, that's the first complaint I've heard about it.
There he is, looking more handsome than ever.
You call this your best work? You're robbing me blind.
Oh, shut up, and go deafen the masses with your wailing.
Thanks for the help. Here's your drachmi. I need some time to put a high cost through his paces. I might need some help after, though, so swing by my tent when you have a minute.
Sure, if I'm in the area.
The Mystias returns. Do you have time to accompany me and Achaikos to our triumphant performance?
After all this, I wouldn't miss it.
Excellent. We team up once more.
So we're a team now. Can I still expect to get paid?
After my performance, drachmi will be in no short supply. Trust me.
You've dedicated your life to your art. You must have a lot to show for it.
I write 100 poems every night when I go to sleep, and I throw out 100 every morning when I wake up. Luckily, some have survived to touch people.
Do you have any favorites?
There's one I'm well known for that is very dear to me. The most beautiful thing I leave is the light of the sun. Second are the shining stars and the face of the moon. Then ripe cucumbers, apples, and pears too.
Sounds nice. But we should get going. So, cucumbers!
The sun gives us the fruit of the trees, like the fruit of the loins.
In your poem, you say you leave the sun. Why?
Not me. Avernus. He's being asked upon death about the most beautiful things he's left behind.
To me, there is no greater beauty than that of the sun,
and the moon, and stars.
Why is he being asked this?
Adonis is beauty incarnate. What could be so beautiful that even he would be paying to leave?
I see. Looks like we've made it.
Marvelous. Thank you. Looks like my adoring fans are ready for me.
It's Praxila!
I heard she was coming this year.
Praxila! Recite something for us.
I've been reciting this poem for years. Cassandra, would you do me the kindness of allowing me to hear it anew from your lips?
I couldn't.
Nonsense. You know everything you need to do it justice.
How about something new this year?
The most beautiful thing I leave is the light of the sun.
Praise be Apollo!
Second are the shining stars and the face of the moon.
This is one of my favorites.
Then, ripe cucumbers, apples, and pears, too.
That's always been my favorite verse.
I'm happy my poem touched you so deeply, Cassandra. Have you thought about trading your spear for the lyre?
I will stick to swinging swords, thanks.
It wouldn't be a poetry festival without someone causing a disturbance.
Praxila, get to safety. I can handle them.
Every year, some cursed idiots drink too much wine and get themselves killed.
I didn't know poetry festivals were such lively events.
Indeed. I need to take a moment to recover. Let's go back to my tent.
Ah, but we do have a happy ending.
Praxila. It has taken me long years of soul-searching and many nights of tears to bring myself to this moment. I am Archimedes, your son.
When I heard the name of the man who stole my lyre, I suspected it might be you.
I've dreamt of hurting you as you hurt me and my father 1,000 times. But I only knew you as the mother who abandoned me and not as the artist that I just saw.
Just as Adonis lamented the beauty he left behind, I too left that which was most precious to me on the death of my old self.
You're not dead. Neither of you are. Take this opportunity and see what you can build together.
Thank you for all your help.
By Zeus! I would have been a goner there if it wasn't for you.
Lucky I came by.
Pleased to make your acquaintance. I'm Epi. Well, Epizilos, but my friends call me Epi. Not that I have friends, necessarily.
I'm Cassandra.
Charmed. You have the look of someone used to being out in the world.
You have the look of someone who... spends a lot of time reading.
I don't look like much, it's true. But when discovery knocks, what other choice is there? I have, in my possession, a Mykenaean tablet that leads to a sacred burial site. I'm calling it the Cave of the Oracle.
Good for you.
Mykenaeans were known for their elaborate grave sites, full of precious things.
How precious?
Ancient jewelry, ceremonial swords and daggers, so very precious. If you escort me, I'll show you.
How can I turn down the promise of precious things?
The fates have delivered you onto my path, and thus we travel together.
The fates have been known to have a sense of humor.
Happening of... is fortuitous.
Glad to hear it. So, you dig through book roll?
No. Well, yes and no. I dig through dirt, too.
That's what farmers do.
I uncover our history. Sometimes, hopefully this time, we'll uncover ancient wonders.
I hate to break it to you, but clay pots and dirt aren't that wondrous to most.
I've dedicated my life to it. It's so much more than treasure to be looted.
Is it, though?
It's who we are. Knowing where we come from tells us where we are headed.
You educated people and your riddles.
Some people don't care about the past. They only want to steal something
It will make them a few drachmi. Imagine that.
Hard to believe.
My peers are no more than treasure hunters and art dealers.
Well, you did mention precious jewels.
These ruins and relics are notoriously hard to find. I found this one. Clever searching and deduction.
Tell me more about it.
Mykenians held specific rituals. Some tales speak of objects made by the gods.
Yes, the gods like to play their hand on occasion.
Think of this, Mystios. How would you like to have had the gods help you in battle?
A good warrior doesn't need any help from the gods or anyone else.
True. True. But think of what we might find there.
You think we'll find something with this power?
See? Now are you interested?
I certainly am. The Oracle of Trophonius. I wonder if the cult's working here, too.
What's this?
Stay back.
They seem drawn to this place. I hadn't expected that.
Does this have to do with whatever that name was you said?
The Mykenians? I don't see how they could know. It must be related to Trophonius. I'll observe them and see what I can learn.
Fine. I'll search further inside.
Wait! Take this steely piece. See if there are markings that match it.
Not much of a burial site. Mules are buried in higher places of honor. The steely piece looks like it can be placed. This is... unexpected.
elaborate than I thought. This statue depicts a warrior. Ah, this is more like it. Let's see what we have. Oh, the markings match Epi's stone. Want to see all of this. We're in the right place. Unfortunately, my friend, it's been looted. All I found was this armor.
That is highly significant. The Mykenians were a warrior culture, you know. So this must be a warrior's tomb.
Well, it's a decent piece, but where's the rest of it?
That was only one part of the stele. If we can find the others, I can decipher the text.
Maybe that will reveal more armor. The rest of the stele you speak of could be anywhere.
If I can find clues for where to look, are you interested in finding the other stele pieces?
I'll look for the others.
Excellent! Now, I need to see those markings. Let's go inside. I didn't expect the stele keystone to actually be a key.
I wonder what happens when all of them are in place.
Even with only part of the stele, I can start to decipher the writing.
What does it say?
I think that says, of the gods.
Really? To think you were someone yelling for help not long ago.
Look at me now.
I think you're going to need all of them, though.
According to this, it seems that the stele pieces have been deliberately separated.
I wonder why they were separated on purpose.
It doesn't matter if we can find them. Will you look for the other stele pieces?
Of course. Where should I look?
According to this, the next stele is... Oh, better you than me. I can't swim. Explore the ruins of Arni.
What's the connection between this tomb and those worshippers?
The writing mentions of the gods. It's not clear which gods, though. Once we decipher more, we should understand the connection.
The armor must belong to the ancient warrior. But why remove it and spread it out across the lands?
Good question. It must have something to do with the text.
So these markings are an ancient language?
Mykenian. There are languages even older than that. Thank you. which have been lost. When this died out, sadly, we fell into a dark age.
Time for me to go.
Thank you. ημών προσφορά. Εκλυπαρούμε του ελέγχου.
Thank you. Thank you.
These statues are incredible. The sculptors truly are masters of their craft. Your clue was right. I found a part of the stele, along with another piece of armor.
There must be a piece of armor with each missing stele.
But why?
This section here refers to a ritual.
It doesn't explain why the armor was separated and hidden with the stele piece.
Maybe that was part of the ritual? We need to find the other stele pieces. Are you ready?
If we found these, then we'll find the other stele pieces too. I'll go look.
Even with the full keystone in place, some of the meaning may be lost on us.
I have faith in you.
Oh! You won't believe what this section says. Of the primordial gods. primordial.
That's interesting.
That's ancient.
It could just be a prayer on behalf of the warrior.
That's what I thought too, until I read this part.
There is more?
It mentions that the ritual will be activated.
What ritual?
I have no idea. I'm presuming it means we need all of the steles in place before something happens.
Do you have the location for the missing piece?
This text is hard to make sense of. It appears to be a warning. Be careful when you explore the tomb of Orion.
I'll be careful. The Dark Age has had its time. Why look backward?
There is truth and insight in looking backward. Take Homer, for example. He often spoke of our past in his stories.
Huh. So digging through dirt and cobweb words is your ambition?
My role is to breathe life into the ancients.
Do any of your peers support you in this?
None. My ways are too different for them.
If you're right, you'll gain their respect after this. Do you worry that your expectations are too high? It may be a dead end.
How can it? The clues have proven me right thus far. The Steely mentions a ritual that, once performed, will activate something.
What does that have to do with primordial gods?
I have no idea. When we have all the Steely pieces, we'll know.
Time to go.
Προσδόκητον του πελάτου και σε θεμελιώστε τα δεδομένα και μετά.
Thank you. tsunami.
Watching you.
Ah!
τύχη!
Sparta! I will tear your
Thebians. Cowards that surrendered to Xerxes.
Stay away! What would you like? My thanks.
So you never hustle again. I'll enjoy this.
Whatever you're after, you're too late. They're all gone. Dead or mad.
I don't understand. Who did this to you?
I don't understand it myself. My brethren and I were drowned in this place, but madness took over. We fought over the artifact. One of them grabbed it and ran.
Grabbed the Steely?
Searched the caves. That's where they'll be hiding. Beware the... They're beyond reason.
can't have it!
Was the Steely influencing them in some way?
Only the finest goods.
There may be some truth in this lore.
Oh, is that blood on it?
It's otherwise undamaged. There are people claiming that it speaks to them. What could do that?
Strange. I don't hear anything. Do you?
Words of madmen. Perhaps the next pieces will tell us more.
This one needs a good cleaning. Let's hope the remaining ones are fine.
I'll search for the remaining steles.
My peers will finally listen to what I have to say. It says the ritual will activate something. But what? What will happen when we have all the pieces? Will it lead to a treasure? Some of the translation is lost on me. This passage speaks of worth.
Hmm. What else?
This passage mentions something about inner vision. But the meaning is unclear.
It's almost translated. Why aren't you happy?
You tell me others are hearing things. They think it speaks to them. Yet I hear nothing. I feel nothing.
This is an important find. You said so yourself. Why does it matter what others say or feel?
I know. I see that it's important from a logical perspective. But what if I can't experience it? And this mention of worth, what if it means I'm not worthy?
What if the gods are not worthy of us? Look, we aren't done yet, right? So wait and see.
You're right.
Time to dust yourself off and focus.
You're right.
Looking for this?
Oh! Excellent!
Cheer up. Only one stele left to go.
You're right. There's a temple in the city of Orchomenos, near the harbor. You may find it there.
Thank you.
you face, Spartan!
Die!
scars from the Persian War. Let's see what we can find, Icarus.
If it isn't the mighty Mystios with the broken spear, how would you like to raise that blade alongside Spartan warriors?
Depends how much true Spartan warriors can pay.
A capable Mystios such as yourself would be well compensated. Care to share in our upcoming victory against the Athenians?
I'll join you.
Good. We're glad to have your sword.
Oh!